How to become best friends forever with the ZModeler Brush. Part two of the series. The first one was say hello to the ZModeler Brush. Becoming friends with the ZModeler Brush seems to be difficult for many people, I've noticed. I have a firm belief that all it takes is to invite it out to play a few times, and you'll soon be fast friends. I realize that sometimes it acts like an obstinate playmate who doesn't want to tell you what they like or what they want to do. But I have faith that if you just play with it and explore its features, you'll be best of friends in no time. Those of you who have been around ZBrush for a while probably know what I mean when I say that when Pixelogic comes out with a new feature, it isn't always apparent immediately just how it works. They do a great job of designing tools that, with a little direction in their operation, anyone can make amazing things happen in no time. Now the ZModeler Brush is no exception. In fact, it's one of their most powerful tools, I believe. Many people seem to be intimidated by it or just don't understand how it works, and it isn't self-apparent. And there are certain things that can happen that cause problems. For instance, maybe you're trying to go into dynamic subdivision mode by hitting D and nothing seems to be happening. Hit D and nothing happens. Or let's say you hover over an edge, hit spacebar, and bridge, and you want to bridge these edges here. As you can see, nothing happens. You can spend a lot of time wasting trying to figure that one out. One thing that can cause this problem is when you have something hidden, and ZBrush won't tell you what the problem is. It just won't cooperate. So if you delete hidden or unhide it, like I've deleted hidden up on my interface here instead of in the tool palette under geometry, modify geometry. Notice that it went right into dynamic subdivision because I had pushed D. Hit shift D to get back out of that. Lo and behold, it'll bridge as well. That's the problem I was going to cover today. If you have a problem with it not doing what you want, you might want to check to see if you have anything hidden. There are some really super uber cool features that the ZModeler Brush does. I'm sure you know what insert single edge is like. That's one little edge. Let's go to multiple edge loops. I'm going to assume that you know to hover over an edge or a polygon or a point to bring up the various contextual menus. Depending on which you hover over and which feature you're focusing on will determine what menus pop up. For instance, I just switched over from single edge to multi-edge. Check out all the modifiers. I like this feature. I'm going to put it on interactive elevation. It's on interactive resolution, which means that when you start to draw out an edge loop, if you go to the right or left, that happens. Or if you go up and down, you get more resolution, more edge loops. So right and left will determine the elevation, and up and down will determine the amount of edge loops you get. So you can get some really cool things going on with that one. There's various modifiers here I haven't played around with much, but I've got you pointed in this direction, and this should give you lots to play around with. I'm going to set this, the H divide, to 24, because I'm going to do some precise editing later. And let's do this, and turn it into a Polymesh 3D. Paul Gabriel says he never uses the cylinder that's in the new initialize palette. The cylinder has some problems. Let's just jump the resolution up a little more. Now, there's a couple reasons he doesn't use this. Notice the spans here. These are narrower than these spans here. And the other reason is that you have this odd shape here. This is a quad. To make this work out right, it has to draw it like that for it to be all quads. And the problem lies when you start dividing up, you end up with not a very smooth cylinder. And there are ways to fix this. It's just, it's a little time consuming, a few seconds, a minute or two. That's the reason that he always uses the 3D primitive cylinder. Polygon, spacebar, inset, flat island, so that I can, oops, I want to set it to inset region, not inset each polygon, because I want it to do this whole shape like that. And click on the other side to duplicate it. Now, I'm going to erase these, delete them, turn double on. Now, hover over an edge, space bar, close, set to concave hole, and you get pretty much what close holes will do. Now, I can show you on this part of it. Let's just delete these and hover over the edge, spacebar, switch it back to convex hole, and you draw out. Notice that is awesome. That is so cool. That was converged to center. You can converge to edge, which means that it'll converge to the edge you first click on, like so. Converge to point, which will converge to the nearest point of wherever you click, like so. And I'm going to go back to converge center. There's also 360 degree twist. This is a neat, cool one. And the more resolution you give it, the more it'll twist 360 degrees. And you may have noticed that there's also a slider here for a twist amount. Let's do 180. I've really actually not tried this, so. Yeah, it doesn't go all the way around, just partially. And that should give you enough to play around with as far as those closed hole options. They're really cool. When I first was playing around with ZModeler Brush, there's a delete edge, and I tried to delete edges, and it just didn't work. So I'd always have to go to Insert and then do Alt, and then a delete. Well, I found out that delete edge will delete edges of triangles. As long as when you delete it makes a quad, it will delete the edge. Like, for instance, if you try to delete this now, it won't do it, or that, because it's going to leave you with a shape that's not a quad. So this can be very handy. Sometimes you wish that you didn't have the triangles. They're not always bad, but sometimes you just don't like them. Or maybe you do. So if you have been wondering why delete does not delete the lines you want it to, it's because it's a specialized delete. It's for taking care of triangles, like so. That could be handy. There's also hover over point, shift, choose bridge, and 2 points. This means you can bridge 2 points, like so. There's also a ring, and that opens up more modifiers. Click on any point, and it'll connect with any of the nearby points. And there's certain modifiers, like crease ring, regroup ring, or do not crease, and do not regroup. So, like, right now, what it did was it creased all the way around in a ring, and it made a new group. So that's what bridge points does. And there's one feature I haven't got a grip on yet. It's a line edge. Let's try this one. Oh, that's pretty cool. Make a guitar pretty easily with that shape. Not quite what I was going to do, but that's it for this video. We'll see you in part 3 when we continue to build a guitar. Hope that you found some of this useful and helpful. Take care.